Now I request the next speaker, Mr. Kapil Verma, to make his presentation. He is a mechanical engineer from IIT Roorkee. He is presently working as deputy director at Allahabad. Your presentation, please.
Thank you, Omar sir, for your informative presentation. The expectations lie high on me now. Good afternoon, esteemed dignitaries and builders of the nation. I welcome you all to my concept paper on database management for effective works monitoring. In this smart age of information technology, information is God. The timely retrieval of the information and conveying it correctly to the right source is the key to effective management. Here I'll go with my presentation with a brief introduction on the DBMS across the globe, relevance to MES on a conceptual level, and then I'll be giving some practical examples. A database management system is a computer software designed for the purposes of managing databases. It is used to store, modify, and extract the information. DBMS are designed to manage large bodies of information, which includes collection of interrelated data and a set of programs to access those data that contains information relevant to an enterprise, that is tailor-made. The primary goal is to provide a way to store and relevant database information that is both convenient and efficient. Management of data involves defining structures for storage of information, providing mechanisms for the manipulation of information while ensuring the safety of the stored information even if the system crashes, as well as if there are attempts to unauthorized access. Database widely used in almost every enterprise today as listed here. In my personal opinion, the banking and the railways has actually affected the life of the common man in a big way. These are the various platforms used across the globe for managing the databases. As we all know, Oracle is the biggest platform where which is providing customized solutions to the various enterprises. The last one, FileMaker, I'll be covering in my following slides. DBMS in vogue and used by various organizations are listed here. We all must have heard about them. Various organizations are using different modules of these particular type of DBMS. The last one, Enterprise Resource Planning, is definitely the largest platform in which the most of the organizations in the country are running their customized softwares for database managements. In present scenario, billions of bytes are added daily by means of various forms of DBMS. The management of big data, that is Hadoop, is being talked about as the next big thing in the software industry. With this, I'll conclude my first part of the introduction while saying that this is the right time when MES as an organization, we should switch over to customized software providing the DBMS across the country. The benefits will be described in my following slides. I come to the next portion with the relevance of DBMS in military engineer services. MES is the largest construction agency in the country. We are definitely the largest service providers too. We employ a large number of manpower and we hold huge amount of inventory. So that qualifies us to switch over to a customized solutions. Present state of managing data in MES, definitely by the means of reports and returns, which follow a periodicity and which follow the same cycle. They are made at the subordinate formation levels. Subordinate formations transfer to higher formations, and higher headquarters keep on compiling these reports almost on a repetitive basis. Why we need? We need a centralized report monitoring system where the data input is the responsibility of the subordinate formations. Compilation and interpretation is the software's responsibility. The higher headquarters in turn can access and interpret the data on the requirement basis. How to go about it? We need a nodal section at the headquarters level, maybe at the ENC branch level, at the command level or the chief level, which have a central server dedicatedly for this purpose, which is maintained and managed by the qualified software professionals whose role will be to make standardized formats and forms for the to be used by the subordinate formations as per the organizational requirements. One of the modules could be the human resources management, because with this module we can have a ready reference for the index cards. We all remember that we had been filling the index cards quite repeatedly every year. That is the basic data. Right from the when we get the appointment letter, those data should always be available with the higher headquarters. including education and graduation details, specializations, salary increment status, the leave details, and when all these informations are correctly compiled properly, then definitely we can produce the online PTOs also. How do you enter the data? In this age when we have digital signatures being issued to the officers, let the digital signatures be issued up to the OS level or at least up to the ADM officer level, so that they can have an access and they can enter the data. The next higher officer can vet it. Even if we don't want to go to that ground level at the very first stage, let's compile this data at the CRO level. The officers will have a login ID and a password so that they can access their online service book. They don't have an access, they don't have authorization to amend it, but yes, they can. If they found any anomaly, they can report the matter to the CRO. Similarly, the CWE office is holding the service books of the subordinates in industrial staff. They can have that access. Next big thing I see is the inventory management. Inventory management, I'm talking on the two aspects. Number one is the storekeeper's inventory for the day-to-day spares. He can have an online record so that it can be accessed by the officers. Secondly, the inventory of the station assets, particularly the E&M assets. If one station is holding an access transformer, they can list it on the central server. The other stations can use it, use the information, and they can call for the transformer with the recommendation of higher headquarters and the approval of the higher headquarters. So in the inventory management, we need to do the listing. The data needs to be entered. The biggest advantage I found is the analysis part. The patterns and the trends of the fast-moving item, the slow-moving items can be easily seen by the software itself. And thus, and yes, we can have the access of that data in whatever way we want. So with the inventory management, if correctly in place, maybe after some years, we can actually generate our maxima and minima demands with the usage of this inventory management system. Next, we can have a central inventory of the architectural drawings as well as the standardized designs. For example, a PEB hangar has been designed at one zone. Drawing is available, design is available. Let the other zone also use it. Why we keep on reinventing the wheel every time? Contracts. Say my zone has a design perfectly drafted a 60-ton central AC plant with a specified temperature conditions. Let the other zones also use it. Now I'll come to the relevance of DBMS and the military engineering services at the micro level for the ground executives. Here I want to convey the message to the ground executives, that is particularly AGs and the Gs, to use some software or utilize the technology available and very handy tools available with us so that they can monitor their day-to-day working and yes, definitely become the smart managers. MS Excel, we all know, we all had been using it. I will only say that the Excel what we use in a day-to-day working, making QPRs and MERs, is hardly the 10% of what the software is capable of doing it. It is actually a very, very powerful tool. I'll not dwell upon it because we all have been using it. I'll directly switch over to MS Access. MS Access is a much more powerful tool. The interlinking between the forms, we can create the forms. The interface is very good. This is how it looks like. See, this is the one which is produced at an AG level or maybe at the G level. At the one blink, for one particular work, we are having access to all the data which that work can give to us. Once the data is entered, we can play around with the data anyway. See, I want to see how many works. As you see in this slide, total number of 89 works are with me. I want to see my one particular J.E. Praveen, how many works he is holding. He is holding 34 works. So the search options are there. This is very easy. MS Access provides these solutions very easily. Similarly, I can see how many minor works, how many CW power works are there. I can see, customize my searches with the job number as well. So I can produce the reports. So the advantages are many. Now, in my last slides, I'll just concentrate on the smart age. Like in the smart age of tablets, smartphones, where synchronization features are very well available. The FileMaker Pro offers good solutions. I'll concentrate on the Bento. The FileMaker Pro is available on all the platforms, whether it is Google, Android, Apple, and Microsoft also. This is the one produced by the Bento. The interface is almost same as the Access. Yes, they are more beautiful, and they are more handy, rather. This is produced from the G's perspective. I'll not go field by field. We can all see that these are the generally fields which are required to identify a work. Why it is required? Because once the data is entered, the planning team, sanctioning authority, contracting team, ground executives, audit authorities, inspecting authorities can interpret the data as per their requirement. That's the main advantage what I feel when we customize our database management. Not only from the ground executive point of view, the E2 planning section, this is the one which is produced for the E2 planning section. At one go, we can see all the possible fields pertaining to one particular work. We can see how many, as per the work operational orders, tender one is allocated to CWE, the TS is issued, tender number two is allocated to chief, TS is issued. This is over data actually. We can always list down how many A part one items are there. From contract point of view, we can see which contracts are concluded, which are not. In this age of cloud drives, where the Evernote is present, where the Dropbox is present, where the cloud synchronization is there, it is very easy to synchronize the data across all the devices. It is convenient to work on a PC as well as laptop. We can work there and synchronize the data on our tablet as well as a smartphone, and we can carry it so that we can give the real-time feedback to anybody.
Can you conclude, please?
Sir, I'll conclude with this. I'll summarize with the use of smart DBMS. It adds value to the work and differentiates the traditional managers with the smart managers. I'll conclude my presentation with a thank you.